I'd like to invite you today to join me on a short trip as I drive towards Nashville. You can see the surrounding areas, both sides of the road, and we are currently cruising at a steady 70 miles an hour pace, steady speed going on a relatively straight road. Okay, what do we see? We are certainly seeing the change in weather. It is cloudy. The trees on either side of the highway don't have any more leaves left. Maybe some shrubs still do, but that's about it. It's relatively early in the morning, although the clock shows it's close to noon. It's about 2 or 3 hours earlier, so I'm not sure even how to change the time on the camera, but we are passing small towns and villages. There are relatively few cars on the road right now. You can see the cars passing in the other direction as we go under the bridge and continue along the way. Slow and steady, well, not really slow, but definitely steady, obeying the speed limit. The weather is nice and warm at around 55 degrees, but it's certainly cloudy. The road is straight with a few potholes here and there. Nothing major yet. We're driving from almost the border of, or rather the state line with Alabama, all the way to Nashville. You might be able to see a couple of ads for hotels and motels on the right side. Restaurants. You can see the cars passing us. Those cars are the speeders. That's right, we are fully obeying the law. Look at the sky, how it's changing. It's clearing up a bit more as we approach another exit. To the right of us, right here, Columbia, Lewisburg. Here it is coming up in about a mile or so, just on the right side. And there is also a gigantic billboard on the right advertising another restaurant. somehow the colors are distorted because the grass is really not that bright yellow, but the light changes as the exit approaches right here, but we keep going. We're not yet getting off. In fact, we have still quite a bit to go. The cars keep passing us, but that's okay. We have nowhere to rush. Nowhere to go. Alright, another speed limit sign, and we are still obeying the law. There are some trucks on both sides of the road. Another ad for Best Western, I believe. You can see the font is changing a bit with of fir trees intertwined on either sides, mixed foliage. Some trees already lost their leaves, but fir trees stay like this beautiful the whole winter. The road is nice and straight, with a few bumps here and there, but not bad at all. The road will get closer. As we get closer to Nashville, we'll get a bit bumpier. Some people disregard the speed limit altogether, and maybe right now it doesn't matter. But when the animals are active, it's a threat to them for sure. It's, and sadly, there are a lot of animals that are killed on this road. And because it's a highway and there are wooded areas on both sides of this highway, you might occasionally see a deer right next to the road. They graze. Well, I guess only cows technically graze, but they eat grass. Next exit is coming up as we continue our journey. Some other billboards like that. Maybe there is a hospital at this exit and a gas station. There it is. A mile away, just a bit longer. More billboards. And another car passing us on the left. White car on the left. Here it is, the exit. Right here. And then there is an overpass that we are going under right now. The weather is definitely getting better, without a doubt. We might actually see some real sun very soon. Just like that. speed limit sign. They are actually pretty good informing the drivers of the speed limit here. Although sometimes the signs don't necessarily work well when they have a road work zone and they have signs that contradict one another. Here you can see a little bit of a better view of the view ahead. Imagine when in the summer or spring all these trees covered in foliage. Everything is nice and green. Right now is a dead time of year, but I can tell you that things are still alive if you just look closer. Just have to pay attention to details. The road is nice and dry. The last rain was about 2 days ago, so we needn't worry about slipping or wet conditions today. Not today. Rain is yet to come in the upcoming week, but today we're just driving straight and looking around at the trees, passing cars, the sky that keeps changing, and bumps. These are some serious bumps near Nashville, actually, are the worst potholes. They're not even potholes, they're literally some sort of gigantic caves where if you don't pay attention, you'll definitely hit, and who knows what's going to happen. Have to always keep pay attention to the road and here in the rural areas. Somehow the roads are not yet that bad. It's in the city where they get ridiculous. More billboards on the right. In to rest in case you're tired, if you're a truck driver or just need some time to sleep. Another bridge that we're passing under, some power lines on the top. It's amazing how much you can notice if you just pay attention. Just pay attention. Another sign. This one actually, I believe it's, if I saw it right, just states it's a pesticide test site, and they're warning to not mow. Another car passed us, and was relatively peaceful, but look very closely. It's very much weighed down. Either they have people in the back or a lot of luggage, or maybe even both. And look at the sky, the clouds are almost gone as we pass this car that just passed us. Sometimes people don't really think when they go ahead of you and then slow down right in front. It's quite odd. Here we are in the work zone, and next to the exit where there are lots of gas stations, a lot of options in case you need gas. An abandoned vehicle on the side of the road. It's been there for over a week now. Or at least I think at least a week. We're slowing down a bit. Yes. The car in front of us is a Mercury. I don't know when the last time I saw a Mercury. It's an older car. Here you can see some potholes. And no, we're not yet at or near Nashville. But you can see that the road work is probably going to fix that. Of potholes and other obstacles, but we still keep driving and following this Mercury that somehow just started to brake for no reason. Don't you hate when that happens? I certainly do. And then you have to slow down. There is no reason why they would hit the brakes. But wait. Maybe they had to look at their cell phone. And we keep driving, passing some orange cones on the left side. And we're almost out of the work zone. Here's that sign coming up, and that's it. We're back to our normal speed. The guy in front of us sped away already. Very inconsistent driving, but that's okay. We have nowhere to be. We have time. We have patience. And we relaxed, observing what's happening around us. The truck inspection site is on the right. That's typically where they stop to also get weighed, but this time it's closed. So we just keep going. And then we would stop. We pay attention to the signs. And then a car that has their flashing lights, we just pull to the side to give them space and get back into our lane. Here's that truck station where they can check their brakes. And sometimes even take a nap. You often see a bunch of them staying here overnight, sleeping. Another car passing us. And we are approaching a gigantic truck. What are we going to do? But we look. Sky again. I think it looks really pretty. different shapes, colors. Now we're going to pass this truck safely and give the truck enough space. And then we're going to get back into our lane to allow everybody else to go. Just like that. And we are driving, still driving. I don't know if you were able to see deer. Deer were just enjoying the sale themselves on the right side of the road. And there they should stay, not cross the road. And we keep driving with another truck passing us on the left. Keep driving. Another car. I never was a big fan of these boxed cars with 90 degree angles or so. We're seeing some more traffic now. We're getting closer to Nashville, but not yet there. In fact, our destination is in Franklin, just before we reach Nashville. Franklin seems to be quite a nice area. Another bridge. We'll see more towns as we drive through. Most of them are pretty isolated, even though they're next to a big city. Another car on the left, passing us as we approach another bridge. With an exit, Spring Hill, Columbia, but we're not getting off just yet. We keep driving and observing this truck tailgate, the car, another big highway, not highway. Now there are three lanes. Stay away from the aggressive drivers because it's best just protect yourself. We approach another road work area and the speed limit is going down here. In fact, the right lane is going to merge to become the two-lane highway again. As we go ahead and get into that work zone with multiple signs warning us, I rarely see people slow down for road work here. Maybe because typically on weekends there isn't any work going on. Multiple flashing signs, the warning of a new speed limit, but we just keep going. The sky changes so often. It's unpredictable what the weather is going to be. There's some construction on the right going on. And then we're out of that low speed zone. Here in Tennessee, 70 is a pretty usual thing compared to roads in Long Island, New York, and that's where at some point I lived on the East Coast. So my point of reference. We're trying to avoid the potholes the best we can, as now they're becoming more and more frequent. Another car passing by. And then we're seeing another sign. Another sign. It's getting cloudier again. Something blinking ahead of us, warning us, alerting us. But we don't know yet what it is. It's a sign. And actually, when it looks like it's refreshing constantly. When you look at it with a human eye, you don't see it blinking, as you can imagine. Here is the way to Memphis and Knoxville if you want to go that way. And the highway is kind of subdivided. You can exit that way to go that route. But no, not today, not today. Memphis and Knoxville, 2 miles. We're certainly not going there. But some people are, like this car on the right that is exiting right now. We are, on the other hand, going straight, staying put right here in the middle lane. It's probably the safest spot to be right now, because cars are going to be merging on the right as we connect with other roadways, and people are passing on the left. We're just steady in the middle lane. Ahead of us is another exit and another entry point. That's kind of what I was referring to when cars are merging in. Now, with 3 lanes, it's easier for sure. But as we approach closer to Nashville, the road is going to become wider, allowing more cars to pass. And now we're seeing the HOV lane, the left lane that is going to start up. The HOV lane is only active with the rules Monday through Friday. And since it's towards Nashville, it's only during the morning hours. I believe 7 to 9 a.m. And the HOV stands for High Occupancy Vehicle with 2+ passengers. So if you have more than one person in the car, you can use that lane to bypass so anybody can be in that lane. And we are still steady going. You can see that it gets a little bit busier, both with traffic and also in the surroundings. You'll see more buildings, more structures, more places, advertisements. And we're going to move into the middle lane as it now has shifted. Now it became a 5-lane that just merged to 4. 4-lane road. And we still keep driving. Keep driving. Are passing both right and left, and we're getting to the right lane because we soon might need to exit. We like to prepare ahead of time so that we don't slow down any traffic. Creating traffic jams. Another truck to the left of us. CF High. Don't really know what it stands for. But it's a big, big rig. We keep going straight. Straight right there. More for gas, a sign warning to slow down if the conditions are wet. And this is our exit, a mile from here, exit 65 towards Franklin. We keep going in the right lane. And then get off the cruise control. Just start slowing down for the past half a mile. The exit is visible now to the right. So we're going to exit right here and start slowing down. And then after we get off, we're seeing another truck and a traffic light here at this intersection. We need to make a left turn, but everybody's waiting, so we'll wait behind this car. We want to be in this lane particularly because this lane will then turn right and reach to our destination. Still cloudy. Franklin is to the left, and then another town called Murfreesboro is to the right on road 96. The cars are turning right. Now we can go as well. Slowly proceed and turn in our appropriate lanes to continue going straight. Going on overpass. We'll wait a little bit, carefully proceeding forward. The light has just turned green and we can go. We can move on, passing this intersection with lots more amenities on both sides of the road. We are in town. The hotel is to the right. Not sure if it's Springwood. I don't remember what hotel that is. A gas station. And we're soon approaching our destination, where we will turn right. Right past, there's a Kroger on the right side, a grocery store. But that's not it. We're not going there today. In fact, we're going to a totally different place. But there is a dealership, car dealership on the right, and another gas station. Lots of things to buy. Here is our turn. By getting into the right turning lane, slowing down, and turning. Next, we're gonna follow that car to make a left turn. Looks like it might have rained here. The roads might be a bit wet. We're still following the car. Not intentionally, obviously. And then we proceed towards the shopping center. And we are going to go ahead and park right here, far away from everybody, to give everybody space. Good night.